are about to see a very short film which is going to give you insight into the kind of project Street Survivors India is involved in. Street Survivors India works in Murshidabad district of West Bengal. It's a very backward district, one of the poorest in India. Murshidabad is along the Bangladesh border, and a short and a very brief introduction to this area is that it has very fertile ground, immense human skills in terms of craft, hands, embroidery, brass, jute, lots of jute growing here, lots of silk over here, and yet we call it one of the most underdeveloped districts. Now, we 10 years ago decided to come here and start with education. And we didn't want it to be just any run-of-the-mill school. We started off with Jagriti Public School, which gives equal learning opportunities to all children, and English being the medium of instruction. So it's really a school which is breaking new grounds. We run four or five projects which are all interrelated, education being one, and the other is harnessing of embroidery skills of local women who have no other avenues of earning. Being a Muslim-dominated district and with a lot of innovations, some of the women do not want to venture out home. So what we've done is we have a cooperative where women work on Kantha, and that we've created a market in terms of we have a shop in Delhi. We have many exhibitions all around, all over the country, and we have one or two shops which we have a tie up abroad where they keep our stuff and we get the money as and when the goods are sold. With women having access to income, we believe that automatically her children will get a better deal, because most homes, one man at least, has to go out of the area to earn, whether it's in the metropolitan cities or whether it is to the countries in the Middle East. So this at least ensures that her equation in the family is now better because she's an earning member. Her children get access to books, more food, and her self-empowerment takes many, many strides, because as soon as she earns, that means she becomes part of the decision-making process in the family. Thank you. program which we have is the Damini Rescue Home, where women who have been neglected, abandoned due to physical torture, mental torture, or just that some of her rights have been snatched away, like her land rights or her access to staying in the in-laws home after her husband has gone. Many a time such women are just thrown out with their kids. One of the songs of Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore in Bengali is Jodi tor dak shune keu na ashe tobe ekla cholo re. And in English, if I were to get the song across to you, I'm sure your hair will stand up. It was a song written by Tagore at the time of India's independence, and he gave this call to the youth that, hey, all of you, so what if nobody listens to you? So what if nobody follows you? The people, there are few who have to dare, who have to walk the road to life alone. But don't get disheartened, because when you walk, maybe there will be thorns which will prick. Maybe there'll be doors will people will bang on your face. Maybe nobody will listen to you. But yet, with fire in your heart and with hope in your hearts, just march along. For a day will come when you'll turn back and you'll see there are quite a few following you.
কত দূর লাগে এখানে আসতে 2 kilometers লাগে স্যার
তাই নাকি
থ্যাংক ইউ
Even one of my children from that group passing out looks into the problem of the ordinary person, thinks about the problems of the ordinary, whether he's a doctor or an engineer. Through his life, through his routine work, if he gives that space to ordinary people struggling, I think we've won the battle. You see, education per se is a long process. It takes a good 20 years for the poor to believe in education. It takes a lot because for them it's a daily survival. So like when we go and we say the magic of education, when we try to explain, many a times we are disheartened because they say, and so what? After class 8, 9, there are no jobs going. So it is a big haul for us to make people believe that to remove poverty, there is no other way out except giving equal learning opportunities. Just love to thank all of you for bearing with us, having the patience, and I would love to, and I hope I have enticed some of you, like the spider in the cobweb, to come and share your skill, and in whichever part of the world you are, just to be able to share, to stop a moment, because actually success is in this world if you've made somebody breathe easier. And yet, many mistakes from which we hope we'll learn to be better people.